In this video, we'll try to understand how to find out thermal resistance in case of a composite slab. Now, the arrangement of a composite slab is as shown over here. We have taken into consideration three different materials having the different widths B1, B2 and B3 and different thermal conductivities of K1, K2 and K3 respectively as shown over here. Now, the heat transfer is taking place in one direction, that is suppose X direction. Now, the resistance offered by the material, different materials, they are also indicated over here. So, the resistances are R1, R2 and R3. So, R1 is the resistance offered by slab 1, R2 is the resistance offered by slab 2 and R3 is the resistance that is offered by slab 1. Now, in our previous video, we have already seen that the thermal resistance, we have already derived the expression for thermal resistance in case of a slab. Now, the temperature at the one phase is T1 and at the other phase it is T2, and as temperature T1 is greater than temperature T2 or higher than temperature T2, the heat flow is taking place from higher temperature towards the lower temperature. So, this is the negative slope that we are obtaining over here. T3 and T4, these are the interface temperatures, those also we have to find out afterwards. Now, the temperature difference is T1 minus T2, so that delta T is indicated over here. Now, the resistance offered by the slab 1 is P1 upon K1A, where A is the cross-sectional area through which this particular heat will flow and will be same. We have assumed that to be same for all these particular three materials. Now, this B1 is the width, it is expressed in meter. K1 is the thermal conductivity, it is expressed in watt per meter Kelvin, and cross-sectional area is in meter square. So this meter square and meter, 1 meter will get cancelled up, and that will again will get cancelled up with this meter which is present in the numerator. So, and this Kelvin will again go in the numerator. So we can say that the resistance, thermal resistance, is having the unit of Kelvin per watt. R2 is the resistance, thermal resistance, that is offered by the second slab, so that is B2 upon K2A, and R3 is equal to thermal resistance offered by the third slab, that is B3 upon K3A, and summation of the resistances is R1 plus R2 plus R3 because all these three resistances, they are in series. Now, the use of this particular thermal resistance circuit is that we can easily find out the heat transfer rate as well as the interface temperatures. So, as we have already derived, Q is equal to change in temperature divided by summation of resistances. So, change in temperature is T1 minus T2, and the resistances which are present between these two temperatures, they are R1, R2 and R3. So, it is R1 plus R2 plus R3, that is nothing but summation of R. Now, using this particular concept, we can find out the interface temperatures T3 and T4. So, if you consider the temperature difference T1 minus T3, so we are considering these two temperatures T1 minus T3, then in the denominator, we have to consider only the resistance R1. Suppose we are considering the temperature difference T1 minus T4, then we have to consider two resistances which are there between T1 and T4, that is R1 plus R2. Similarly, if we consider only the temperature difference T4 and T2, then we will have to take into consideration only the resistance, that is R3. So, as it is a steady state heat conduction, Q will remain same in all the cases. So, from this particular equation, we can find out the interface temperatures T3 and T4. Now, we'll consider the case in which two different fluids, they are present on the either side of this particular composite slab. So, suppose fluid 1 is having heat transfer coefficient of H1 and temperature of T1, and another fluid 2, it is having heat transfer coefficient H2 and temperature is T2, and it is present on this either side of this particular composite slab. Then in this particular case, resistance R1 will be given, it is between the fluid and this particular solid surface. So, the heat transfer will be by convection between this fluid and this solid surface of the first composite slab. So it is 1 upon H1A. H1 is the heat transfer coefficient whose unit is watt per meter square Kelvin and area is in meter square. So this meter square will get cancelled up. So we'll again have the unit of Kelvin per watt. R2 is nothing but it is the thermal resistance offered by this first slab, that is B1 upon K1A. then R3 will be equal to B2 upon K2A, that is the resistance offered by the second slab as we have seen earlier. Then R4 is equal to resistance offered by this third slab, that is B3 upon K3A. And again, from this solid surface to the fluid, it is the resistance that is offered by convection. So it is 1 upon H into A or H2 into A, where H2 is the heat transfer coefficient for this fluid 2. Now again, the overall temperature difference is T1 minus T2, so that we have indicated over here. All these resistances, that is R1 and R4, R5, these are the resistances because of the convection, whereas R2, R3 and R4, these are the resistances due to the conduction. And all these resistances, they are in series, and therefore summation of R will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 plus R5. Now the overall temperature difference is T1 minus T2. And the resistances which are present between this T1 and T2, they are nothing but R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 plus R5, that is nothing but summation of R. Now, using this particular concept, we can easily find out the various interface temperatures. So, for example, if we consider this temperature difference between T1 and T3, then in the denominator, we have to consider only resistance R1. So, we can easily find out the value of T3. Suppose we consider T1 and T4, then between this T1 and T4, there are two resistances, R1 plus R2. So those we have considered over here. Suppose we consider the temperature difference T1 and T5, then between this T1 and T5, the resistances which are present are R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this should be R3. And between, if we consider the temperature difference, so this has to be the R3 part, not R5. And suppose we consider the temperature difference T6 and this T2, then between this T6 and T2, only one resistance is there, that is R5. So that we have indicated over here. So in this way, you can find out these interface temperatures T3, then T4, then this T5 and T6. So in this way, we can find out the thermal resistance in case of the composite, in case of a composite slab having conduction as well as combined conduction and convection. Thank you very much for watching.